Howdy, my name is Michaela. Have you ever walked along a trail in a park or while you were camping and seen a print in the dirt or sand and wondered what animal made that track? Well, wildlife professionals who are concerned about Texas quail wonder the same thing. They set up scent stations to find out what potential predators or animals like to eat quail or their eggs and to see if they're in the area. The stations are set up in an area where quail have been seen, and the tracks left behind are usually by animals that would be most likely to threaten the quail. It's called a scent station because a potential predator is attracted to a scent tablet, or in our case, bait. They then walk over the area of dirt covered in flour to get to the bait and leave their tracks behind as proof. A track identification guide with animal tracks can then be used to find out who made the track and if they're a possible enemy of the quail. To get started, you need to print out the directions on how to build a scent station. This can be found on the kids section page near the scent station button. Since you have the directions already, you should also have the materials needed to build your own scent station. Let's check and make sure I have all my materials. I have my 3-pound bag of flour, my hula hoop, and my bait, and today we'll be using salmon. I also already checked the weather to make sure that it wouldn't be raining over the next couple days. Rain can easily destroy the flour and make the tracks unreadable. Now that I have everything I need, let's go find a spot for my scent station. You need an area large enough to lay down the hula hoop, and ideally your scent station will be set up on a trail that the animal uses. If you find the perfect spot but there's a lot of tall grass in the area, ask an adult to use a weed eater to clear out the area so you have a smooth surface. This spot looks pretty good. I'm going to go ahead and clear anything out of the way that would mess up the flower, just to make sure my area is as smooth as possible. I'm trying to make sure that this is as even as possible, but it needs to be about 1/2 inch thick. While making your scent station, if you think you can't get it done on your own, make sure to ask for help from an adult. When you're done spreading the flour, you want to make sure it's smooth so you can tell whether or not a predator's been here. You can bring a small broom or use your hand to smooth out any areas that are really uneven. Before I leave, I want to make sure that things actually will be able to leave tracks, so I'm going to use a knuckle test. Just push down in the flour, and I can see my own print, so I know that predators will leave a print too. Next comes the bait. It's important to leave the bait in the middle of the circle so the animals have to walk over a good part of the flour before they can get to it. The smellier the bait, the better. Voila, scent station's ready. Rise and shine, today's one day after setting up my scent station. Let's go see if we have any tracks. I went ahead and brought my camera and my track ID, just in case. But it looks like we did have a visitor, and it ate all the salmon. I'm gonna go ahead and take some close-up pictures of the track so I can look it up in my identification book later, or with my parents' permission, help look it up online. We still have one day left, so I'm gonna go ahead and add some more salmon and then smooth out the flour to make sure we still get good results. Go ahead and do that knuckle test one more time just to make sure my prints show up. And we're good to go for today. All right, folks, it's been 2 days and I'm ready to go check out my scent station again. I went ahead and brought my camera and track ID just to make sure in case there's any tracks left, but it looks like we got another one. Once again, all the salmon's gone. I'm going to go ahead and take up some close-up pictures so I can check it out later on. It's important when you're done with your scent station to clean up all of your materials so that it looks just like it was when you originally found it. I've got a trash bag and a scoop I'm going to go clean it up with, and then we'll go back and check out these prints online.
So these are our pictures from day one. It looks like what we had on our scent station then was some kind of a raccoon. But on day two, we had a different animal. That one was actually a cat. I'm not sure how often wildlife professionals come across cats at their scent station, but I do remember reading that raccoons are predators of quail eggs, so we did catch at least one enemy of the quail. With my parents' permission, I'm going to post these pictures on the Wildlife and Fisheries Sciences page. Hope you had a good time. Now it's your turn to set up a scent station. Good luck!